Hi everyone, previously we have studied about the Commonwealth period that there wasn't any king ruling there. So in 1600, Charles II was restored as the King of England and this marks the beginning of Restoration period. Restoration period is also called as the Neoclassicism because their works was based on the classical text. Neoclassicism have three stages. First we have in the Restoration period, starting from 1600 to 1700, then the Augustan age, and then the age of Johnson. Now let's look at the historical background of this period. First we have establishment of Royal Society, which was established in 1660. It is the oldest national scientific institution in the world. Next we have the Great Fire of London. It was a huge fire of London that burned on almost central part of the London. It destroyed several houses, churches and most of the buildings of the city authorities. Next we have the Bloodless Revolution. After Charles II, his brother James II became the King of England. Now he was a Catholic and most of the members of the parliament and the people of the country were Protestants. So parliament invited William III of Orange, who was the husband of James' daughter Mary. And he was also a Protestant, so William III invaded England and James II ran to France. So this period between 1688 to 89 is called as the Bloodless Revolution. And this also marks the beginning of parliamentary democracy. In 1660, Charles II also removed ban on theatre. Next we have the Commedia dell'arte, which was flourished in Italy. It is a form of professional theatre. The major characteristics of this professional theatre is that women started performing in theatres. Next we have Comedy of Manners, which is also called as the anti-sentimental comedy. Comedy of Manners questions and comments upon the manners and social conventions of a greatly sophisticated artificial society. Now let's talk about the major writers of this era. First we have John Ryder. He became the poet laureate in 1668. He wrote Solomon and Achitophel in 1681. It is a political allegory written in heroic couplet. The subtitle of this poem is a poem. Next he wrote MacFlecknoe, in which he attacked Thomas Shadwell. It is a mock heroic satire. Next he wrote Essay of Dramatic Poesy. It is a poem in which he attempts to justify drama as a legitimate form of poetry. Next writer is Samuel Butler. He wrote Hudibras. Next we have Jeremy Collier. He wrote Short View of Immortality and Profaneness, in which he attacked William Wycherley, John Vanbrugh, William Congreve, John Dryden and Thomas Duffy. Next important writer and his work is William Wycherley's Country Wife. Next we have William Congreve. His most important work is Way of the World. Next he wrote Double Dealer, Love for Love and All Bachelor. Next we have Aphra Behn, who wrote Orinoco or Royal Slave. It is a short work of prose fiction. Next we have John Gay. He wrote Beggar's Opera. It is a play in three acts. Next we have Thomas Otway, who wrote Orphan or The Unhappy Marriage. It is a tragedy in blank verse. He also wrote Venice Preserved. It is also a tragedy. And next we have Samuel Pepys' diaries, in which he discussed about the Great Plague, the Great Fire of London and the Second Anglo-Dutch War. In his diary, he also discussed about the daily life of 17th century London. Other important writers of this period were Thomas Rymer, Colley Gibber, George Etheridge, John Evelyn, William Dampier, George Farquhar, and John Vanbrugh. So that's it for this video lecture. If you have any query, please post your comments in the comment section. Thank you.